Hello, this is Basic Electronics Engineering. The course code is EC201. The contact hour is 3 lecture classes. The total contact hour is 36 hours. The credit point of this subject is 3. Myself, Dr. Indranath Sarkar, I am the Associate Professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering of GIS College of Engineering, Kollani. This course has 4 number of outcomes. We expect the students will be at the end of the course, the student will be able to demonstrate PN junction diode, ideal diode, diode models and its circuit analysis, application of diode and special diodes. The student also will be explained how operational amplifiers are modeled and analyzed, and to design operational amplifier circuits to perform operations such as integration, differentiation on electronic signals. The students must analyze the concept of both positive and negative feedback in electronic circuits and its applications. The student must develop the capability to analyze and design simple circuits containing nonlinear elements such as transistors, using the concept of load lines, operating points, and the incremental analysis. This course is comprised of 6 number of modules. Each module has the number of class limited, that is 5 number of class assigned to module 1 on basic semiconductors, 7 contact hour assigned to module 2 on PN junction diode and its applications. Module 3 has 8 contact hour on bipolar junction transistor. Module 4 has field effect transistor to describe within 6 contact hour. 8 contact hour assigned to module 5, where feedback and operational amplifier will be discussed. And the 2 contact hour assigned to module 6, where the cathode ray oscilloscope will be discussed. This is the prerequisite required for basic electronics engineering. Normally, prerequisites are essential to understand a certain course. In this case, as the students are entering after class 12 into BTEC courses and the basic electronics engineering is studied in the first year, so here we expect the basic course of electronics engineering progress from the fundamentals of electricity, direct current, devices and circuits, series and parallel circuits, to the study of active and passive components, Ohm's law, Kirchhoff's law, that is Kirchhoff's voltage law and Kirchhoff's current law, as well as Ampere's law. In the modern electronics part of the physics in the 10 plus 2, all these items have been taught. So students should recapitulate these theory as well as mathematical formula before going to opt for basic electronics engineering. So therefore, Kirchhoff's law, especially the Kirchhoff's voltage law and Kirchhoff's current law, as well as Ampere's law, have plenty of applications in the design part of electronics devices. Because basic electronic circuit is normally tells about the component description, that means there are several components exist in basic electronics engineering subject. All these components are defined, its characteristics defined, as well as the combination of such component may produce complex circuitry, and the categories of circuit and its input and output characteristics all have been defined. So basic electronics is an important subject. Here students are going through the description and characteristics of all these components, so that in future, whenever they are interested about circuit realization, they shall recall about the characteristics they have studied in basic electronics engineering. And for this subject, the data sheet validation of each of these components are required to be carried out by the student, because some component whatever studied has limited features to be explained within the class, and there are detailed feature exists in the data sheet, if the student is interested to create some model, then student should deal with data sheet, the how to see the data sheet and how what are the parametric values required to observe from the data sheet will be discussed in the class. So basic electronics engineering is one of the important subject for any engineering domain, because nowadays there are many interdisciplinary projects are going on in which some electronic circuitry exist. So irrelevant of the department, electronic circuit may be applied to many issues. So that is why basic electronics has contribution about the basic characteristics understanding for those components. So students must give full attention about the characteristics as well as description, mathematical equation whenever discussed for each of the components. Now in the course outcome and program outcome mapping, we are seeing that there are 12 number of problem outcomes which are mapped to the course outcome statements. So here as 4 number of course outcome statement exist for basic electronics engineering, they are having different weightages assigned to each of the column of program outcomes, and here 3 depicts the high weightage assigned for a certain mapping, and 2 means the moderate linking, and 1 stands for the least linking, and when there is no link it is kept vacant with a dashed line. Now basic electronics is the foundation engineering subject as well as it is the basic engineering subject. It has the uses of modern tools regarding the simulation of the circuits, as well as it has long term relation to the student regarding the implementation of project. So it's a lifelong learning, weightage is very high, as well as various surrounding that is applications in the surrounding environment exist. That is why basic electronics engineering is mostly a foundation subject. That is why at the initial part of the program outcome 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 has a great linkage with basic electronics, as well as program outcome 11 and 12 are also. So if we look at the modern tool uses, as well as the project initiative, as well as the foundation engineering concept, we are getting higher weightage for the basic electronics engineering with those program outcomes. And similarly, if we have some long target, that is after a long duration, we have a target to implement certain circuitry which is useful for the mankind, that type of target may be fulfilled, and that is lifelong learning has a great importance on basic electronics engineering, because we sometimes we have a future target of implementing any circuit or applications for the mankind. So that is why basic electronics are getting higher weightage in that part. The course has objective impart fundamental knowledge to understand the basic of semiconductor and components like diode, transistor, FET, MOSFET and operational amplifier. It will be it would build mathematical and numerical background for design of electronic circuit and components value. Students equipped with the knowledge and training provided in the course will be able to participate in the design and development and operation in the different area of electronic systems. So therefore basic electronics has the widest domain of application, because it is dealing with the components which are required to implement electronic circuitry. So all the basic components are included regarding its description, input characteristics, output characteristics. So that is why whenever there is a project related work, basic electronics recalled. So that is why it has a long time application for students of any department, because in any department there is a project realization with electronic circuitry. For any domain, it involves the concept of various components of basic electronics. So therefore, this subject is truly important for any department. Welcome to Basic Electronics Engineering. Today we are discussing cathode ray oscilloscope under module 6. Now we will discuss here the CRO basics and the CRO internal diagram. Normally, cathode ray oscilloscope is a useful instrument. We can say it's a standalone device which is used for measuring the magnitude, phase, as well as frequency. It is actually a time domain representation of signals. Now, the mechanism behind the cathode ray oscilloscope, the main mechanism is that there is a electron beam which is hitting the fluorescent screen, and that produces the impression of the input signal which is fed to the cathode ray oscilloscope. So here the voltage is fed to the cathode ray oscilloscope, and there is some internal mechanism by which the electron beam is generated according to the magnitude, frequency, phase, all these information are generating the electron beam, and electron beam will be deflected within the fluorescent screen so that the impression of the signal can be visualized on the other side of the fluorescent screen. So this is the cathode ray oscilloscope. The cathode ray is a beam of electron which are emitted by the heated cathode, that is the negative electrode, and accelerated towards the fluorescent screen. The assembly of the cathode intensity grid, focus grid, and accelerating anode, that is the positive electrode, are called an electron gun. Its purpose is to generate the electron beam and control its intensity and focus between the electron gun and the fluorescent screen are two pair of metal plates, one oriented to provide the horizontal deflection and the of the beam, and one pair is oriented to vertical deflection to the beam. So these are the two plates, control plates, which are very much important inside the cathode ray oscilloscope to produce the sweep of the signal impression on the fluorescent screen. So these plates are thus referred to as the horizontal and vertical deflection plates. The combination of these two deflections allow the beam to reach any portion of the fluorescent screen. Wherever the electron beam hits the screen, the phosphor is excited and light is emitted from that point. This conversion of electron energy into light allows us to write with points or lines of light on an otherwise darkened screen. And this is the internal diagram of the cathode ray oscilloscope. Here it is clearly visible that there is a heater exists on the left hand side of the cathode ray oscilloscope. This heater is nothing but the cathode which heats the which generates the electron beam, and so heater hits the cathode and cathode emits the electron beam. Electron beam is first passing through the intensity grid, that is controlling the amount of electron passing through the intensity grid. If it is passing more electrons, the intensity will be more. If it is passing less electron, then the intensity will be less. And thereafter, there is a focus grid. The focus grid produces the convergence of electron beam onto the fluorescent screen. So therefore, focus grid plays important role about the impression of signal on the fluorescent screen. And there is a accelerator anode. Accelerating anode is useful to accelerate the electron which are passing through the electron gun. So So therefore, it is a kind of positive voltage which attracts the electron more, but not absorbs, but passes through it with high speed. So gradually acceleration of electron is more. So more is the acceleration, more will be the impression on the fluorescent screen. And there is a deflection plates, that is the horizontal deflection plate and vertical deflection plates. The plates are shown below. The plates which are placed horizontally are actually vertical horizontal plates, deflection plates, because in the horizontal plates, when the voltage is fed, the positive voltage with respect to the negative plate attracts the electron, and therefore the electrons move vertically. And if the vertical plates are applied voltage, then the electron beam is attracted towards the positive voltage more or less, and that is why there is a chance of horizontal deflection of the electron beam. So therefore it is a complementary setup, that is physical setup is complementary to the action. That is, horizontal plate is actually responsible for vertical deflection, and vertical plates are actually responsible for horizontal deflections. And so this is the overall mechanism, internal diagram of the CRO, cathode ray oscilloscope. And in the oscilloscope, the signal to be studied is first amplified and then applied to the vertical deflection plates to deflect the beam vertically, and at the same time a voltage that increases linearly with time is applied to the horizontal plate, thus causing the beam to be deflected horizontally at a uniform rate. The signal applied to the vertical plate is thus displayed on the screen as a function of time. The horizontal axis serves as a uniform time scale. The linear deflection or sweep of the beam horizontally is accomplished by use of a sweep generator that is incorporated in the oscilloscope circuitry. Thank you.